Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, hello and welcome! In a deep, dark, twisted kind of day, I have brought us back to Devil May Cry 2 in hopes that by Thursday, the 3rd? Or the 2nd, I will have the final installment of the Devil May Cry series done. Hello, Mama Strife. Hello, Rain. Let's go ahead and flip this over. Okay. And we are still trying to do this in mission order, in hopes that Dante and Lucia's story makes sense with each other. So, excuse me. So, let's see how this goes. So, we're going to start today with Dante. Mission 5. Alright. Close to your eyes, but far off in your mind, the hunter must learn the value of options. Guidepost for the Hunters. Chapter 5. Clause 4. Desolate are the city streets, born of evil's will. Death's ancient knight sends his familiars to test the will of the hunter. The path is open through death, but guarded still by foes thought vanquished. Fear the machinations of mankind, for easily can they be brought into the service of hatred. A whirling winged one pursues the hunter high into the sky. Close to your eyes, but far off in your mind. The hunter must learn the value of options. Though the enemy stands in the path, escape is wiser than conflict. Notice the full clause. So, let's check our power-ups here. Bam! Boom! Life up. Gotta love the life. Alright. Ow.
Yeah. Damn dog. Oh, that looks like it's gonna be lots of fun later on, don't it? Well, that was fun. Interesting cityscape. Here we go. That was a little painful. All right, another secret mission done. Which I think that was the only thing. Oh look, Monkey Boy's back! Monkey see, monkey slap, bitch! Was that really necessary? That was just rude. Look, he's beating the crap out of me. Damn monkeys! Yes, I am. Oh boy. There we go. Aren't you having fun getting spanked? Well, that really depends on who's doing the spanking. As any person, normal person, will tell you. It's not a question of getting spanked, it's who's doing the spanking. Alrighty. Oh shit. They got a motherfucking tank!
Come on. Owned. Okay. Yes. Okay, so I was right about there being an orb here. And if I remember correctly, another secret mission. Ow! Fuck you, dick! Douchebags, man, every one of them. Okay, so now let's go check up the street here. See, I did actually kind of like the level design for DMC 2. It put it a lot, you know, it actually took you to multiple places and got you out in the open. It wasn't just cramped into one little place, you know, a castle. It's the first time they really took, you know, broadening their horizons and getting out there. We got another heart. The offense heart, a magic stone with the heart of a vigorous battle god. So we have the quick heart, which enables you to move faster and double trigger, and the aerial heart, which lets you fly. Electro heart, and that's our first one for Dante. So, we're still stuck with thunder. Which, given what we're about to encounter, might be a good thing, maybe. So that chart's going to be important a little bit later. Sure, why not? We've already got infested tanks. Why not infested combat or assault helicopters? Why not?
This is probably one of my favorite tracks from it, from DMC2. Yeah, suck it! Suck it! Woo-hoo-hoo. See you later, boy! God, you just don't take no for an answer, do you? See ya! Oh!
Yeah, it must suck to be you. Good, go away. Oh, that just for a little peace and quiet so I can search around this place. Which, I mean, I technically didn't need to do to search around it, but... And there's something around here somewhere. I'm missing something. Okay, I may have to go up a little bit more. Maybe I misread. There it is. I can't go back and get those orbs, damn it. I screwed up. Oh well. Die, bird, die! Bye-bye. Oh goody, he's back. And now the actual boss fight begins. Oh! Oh! Oh. Ow. Finally, Jesus Christ. Minutes to clear that. Yeah, definitely not getting anything better than a D on that one. Alright, so we're doing 6 missions today. And I'm not even gonna hopefully let you read that. Because now. We get to move on to Lucia. It's gonna be a lot of back and forth here for a little bit. So basically, while Dante was climbing that big old tower dealing with piece of shit motherfucking helicopter, Lucia was around. Let's see. Dodge flame tubes and navigate through the cracked city streets so that when the time comes, your path will be shown. Guidepost for the Protectors, Chapter 5, Clause 6. The city of evil is infested with corruption. Only one beat the heart of offense can surmount a city. Dodge flame tubes and navigate through the cracked city streets so that when the time comes, that your path will be shown. And really? I'm actually kind of surprised. Let's see. Alright, got both of her weapons upgraded. And looky, looky, looky what Lucia's got. Offense heart. So now, yeah. Lucia and Dante are about on par. He's got the quick heart and the aerial heart, electro heart, and offense heart. Well, Lucia has the aerial heart, frost heart, healing, and offense, so they roughly measure out the same. Interesting. Lucia didn't get doggies here. Dante did, though. But Lucia gets Monkey Boy!
Hmm.
Now, Strat Guide says Lucia doesn't have any secret missions in this one, and I'm just finding that one really hard to believe. Basically, right back where we started. Okay, yep, nope, nothing there. Two, three. All right, I guess not. Okay, so now this is where Dante got attacked. By Monkey Boy, but over here you can see there's the fiery tanker that blew up, and we have a tank over here now. So while Dante is dealing with helicopter up on top of the tower, Lucia starts heading towards wherever that other helicopter was going. We switch. Back to Dante. I think this makes sense. Should, anyway. Okay, so Lucia arrives at the factory, but upon her arrival, Dante... Or she starts heading towards it Dante's finishing, I think, with Helicopter Dude. I'm not sure exactly timeline-wise, but... Anyway, she makes it to the factory before him because... Not only he has something else to deal with besides the chopper. So, Mission 6. Its extremities reach the sky. Its intestines reflect the color of darkness. Its name means a tower of misery. Guidepost for the Hunters, Chapter 6, Clause 2. The City of Evil is not constructed by the hands of man. The very materials are the bones and sinews of an ancient demon, conjured and summoned to be the brickwork for the sorcerer's schemes. The Hunter has left the city derelict, and so the Ancient awakens. Its extremities reach the sky, its intestines reflect the color of darkness. Its name means Tower of Misery. The Hunter has discovered the deep root of evil. Yeah. And here we go. No, you're not going to give me anything. Like some freaking Nightmare on Elm Street shit going on there. Stupid bats. Dude, I'm not even there, dude. Where the hell are you aiming? He's broken! He just aims down that way. Oh. Bye-bye. Sin City. Hey, I got an A. I'm actually kind of impressed. Oh, Mama Strife, you missed out already.
Sorry.
We're gonna skip that. Because I think. Are we doing this? Okay. Yes. Alright, so. I had to change that as bandage. Okay. Alrighty. So now we get to switch back to Lucia, and we'll be going at her for a couple of minutes. Hey, hey. Oh, ankle popped. Okay. So you got to remember, at this point, Lucia has arrived before Dante. So Lucia has taken the lead here. And now you know why. Alright, so we're gonna take a break. This is the only break we're gonna do. Because we should be able to come back and do the next three missions fairly easy. Because I think Lucia's are kind of short. Just double checking here. Yeah, so these last three missions are kind of short, so this is the only break we're taking here. Should have this still done by the 2-hour mark, so BRB.
Alright. We're back. Last three missions. Let's see what we got. Okay. The Protector must rise to confront destiny head on. Guidepost for the Protectors, Chapter 7, Clause 1. Evil's heart receives its power from the source. The source must be rooted out and exploited so that the hunter may accomplish his task. The Protector must rise to confront destiny head on. Alright. So bear in mind, Lucia arrives first. No electric power. Come on, birds. Murder of birds! Come on, just end already. Damn. You guys take forever to die. Alright, so nothing really important to do in here except
Cranky Bomb. Compact bombs that can be either set or thrown. Thing we wanted to do was come in here. Power has been supplied to all the doors. Through there. That gets us over here. Evil Heart, a demon stone that will absorb the possessor's power.
Come on. Just die already.
Thank you.
And we'll come around there, and boom. Run, Lucia, run! And what did she get here? Flame Heart! Magic stone with the fierce flame demon. So, nothing over here. Seems pretty quiet. Let's go in here. No, I'm good. But in here, you have inlaid the evil heart in the hollow. Boom! And with that, she's got the electro heart, so she's already ahead of Dante and has all three elementals. Nice. Go to Showtime.
Come on, get on the track. Anything breakable? Nope.
So now we just take the lift up. Is her secret room. Ow. I'm actually kind of curious. What was that scruffy for? Collect 12 blue orb fragments as Dante or Lucia. Okay, makes sense. And that will end her mission. And there's our first big glimpse at the big baddie Arius. Alright. Alright, so we got two missions left. This one's gonna be kind of short. And we're gonna keep going with Lucia. Mission 6, the Protector, the King, and the Truth. Guidepost for the Protectors, Chapter 8, Clause 4. Which the full statement reads as, the Protector, the King, and the Truth. Distracted by betrayal, the Protector must overcome the sole denizen of the Otherworld. The path to the Deepwater Temple will be revealed. So, against my better judgment, I'm going to hold off on powering anything up.
is back.
Defect?
You are my creation.
Liar! Mathieu is my mother.
She merely found you when you were about to be disposed of, and then raised you as a soldier. Is that what you consider to be a mother?
No! I don't believe you.
Look. You have the mark on your shoulder. Proof that you're a mannequin. Kai. That is your real name. Now, give me the arcanas. With them, my power will be complete, and I will become like the immortal Argosax. I will achieve absolute wisdom and transcend.
This is like a cheap fucking Bram Stoker's Dracula knockoff.
The world is already warped. Everything that belongs to the devils will eventually revert to its original form. Even you will betray your upbringing and turn on the humans. Accept it.
So we're gonna go and collect these now before I take any damage and they lose their orb value. Don't we just love giant bugs? Yes, sir, Zero. Oh. Really? You had to land on me? How you doing, Zero? Oh. Hey, Synthric! Wait, what? Yeah. Have back and neck pain, got rammed in a stop sign yesterday. Oh, dude, I'm so sorry to hear that. Oh, your poor SUV. Dude, that sucks. Yeah, I got rear-ended in my dad's car when I first got my license. I felt so horrible. Because I was at a complete stop waiting for a car to pass so I could merge into traffic. And dude wasn't paying attention and just slammed right into me. Well, I had my sister in the car, and I had my niece in the car, because we were on our way to Walmart to do some shopping, and my niece was in the middle back seat, and only had the waist seat belt, so she got rocked pretty hard, because dude didn't even realize that I had stopped, and my dad's car was a Buick Park Avenue, Riviera, and dude came at me with a big ass fucking like Ford F-150 truck. So, and he wasn't paying attention because I guess he was looking where I was looking. Ah, come on. And just, yeah, my sister bounced her head off of, she got rocked pretty good. She bounced her head off the dashboard, I think she said, and, I had enough time to briefly react to seeing the truck not stopping in the rear view, and bounced my head off the steering wheel. But yeah, and you know, honestly, like, I have a history of back problems, so, you know, I wasn't exactly, like, super thrilled, and while I was feeling sore, I got over it pretty quick. Okay, bowgun. So, yeah, my back kind of hurt, but I bounced back from it pretty quick. The thing that sucked for me, personally, I just want to double check here. I'm not missing anything, right? I got everything. Got that. Okay, got those. Yeah, we're good. Did the guy at least marry your sister for rocking her so hard? He has to take responsibility for it. Didn't even notice he had a cam. Yeah, I've been using the cam for a while. I wanted to do the cam for when I was playing like horror games and stuff, because you know, hearing the screams only works so much. You really want to see the jump scares. But the thing that bothered me, and this was just my own personal preference of stuff, was the fact that even though I wasn't in the wrong, I felt like it was my fault. I could have done more. I could have done something to prevent that. And my dad was sitting there the whole time just trying to explain to me, no, you couldn't have. You had, there was nothing you could have done. You weren't at fault. And I just felt so bad. That was the mentality. Like, I felt like I had something to do with it and I could have done something to stop it. That's where my mentality was. So even though I was completely not at fault, I still blamed myself to some capacity. And my sister has a pinched sciatic nerve, so that's like even extra for her, you know? Okay, so we're doing, this will be the last mission we're doing tonight for DMC2, and then we're gonna be doing more tomorrow and Wednesday. One, two, and Thursday, in hopes that if I do this right, I will have I will have streamed every DMC game. I feel like I was getting signs to turn back. The freeway was stopped for like 10 minutes. But it could have covered the car and bouncy castles to protect it. You know, that's just one of those weird situations. The dude knew he was at fault. He, his wife, and he had his kid in his car, in his truck. And, you know, he checked to make sure we were all good. But it's still just like, you know, it's one of those situations where it's just like, because I had that brief second of seeing the truck coming. I mean, it was a very brief, like, I had enough time to process the thought, oh shit. That was literally all I could process. I had enough time to process that, and then he hit us. So, I think because in my mind, I had enough time to process that thought, which anybody will tell you is not a lot of time, makes me feel like I could have done something to prevent that. Doesn't matter if I could have or not, it's just that's how my mind works. So, anyway, I'm glad you're okay. Like, did you suffer any real injuries? Because, you know, like I said, I have a history of back issues. So, you know, the fact that, you know, my back got agitated and screwed up a little bit was kind of par for the course. Was the damage mainly to your baby? Or... when you're about to get hit, that nanosecond feels like forever, man. In my mind, if I had enough time to process the thought, oh shit, I had enough time to do something. That's just how my mind works. Well, nobody really ever expects to be hit. Alright, so as we saw here, when Lucia arrived, wait, do I have the aerial heart for him? Yes, I do. Okay. I just want to save myself a little bit of time here. Okay, so... yeah, gold orb there. I think I'm going to need quick heart for this. Now, the only other question is, do I have enough double sugar to get down there? Alright, so that gives him 2. And that gets him the flame heart. So yeah, so when Lucia arrived and then worked her way through here, we saw that as she got to the end of the stage, Aris was just arriving. Dante's, like, this is going back to the whole how you can tell Lucia got here first. Thing worth coming in here for is that. The Vendetta, a decorative sword that is like Death's Scythe. The door is closed tight. So... I think... yes. No, we're not playing this game. Stupid frickin' projectile bullshit. Okay. And then over here. Nothing over here. So just down we go. So Dante arrives, and you can see the chopper laughing. So at this point, while he's heading here, Arius is dealing with Lucia and is handling whatever business he came over to begin with. So. Probably about this time. I'm trying to play the, for those of you who weren't here before, I'm trying to play the DMC2 missions in such a way that Dante and Lucia's missions seem cohesive in their timeline. So, for some parts, I'm trying to explain and make sure I have any gaps filled. Fuck you. Yeah. Totally isn't taken out of an RE game. Actually, this environment in general looks like the realistic some from an RE canceled game we're used to here. Well, considering what Devil May Cry started out as, I wouldn't be surprised if that was possible. If that was essentially a thing. Gimme! Yes.
You bastard, you ruined my combo.
Alright, another blue orb fragment done.
God, man, I swear, trying to S rank in this game is fucking difficult.
Alright. So that's it for tonight.
Yeah.
About 2 hours, 10 minutes. Okay. So that's it for tonight. That's 6 missions. So Dante is on mission 8. And Lucia is on mission 7. Dante has 18 missions. Lucia has 13. So we're coming up pretty quickly here. So we're going to be getting a lot of Dante play over the next few episodes. Tomorrow's episode is going to be primarily Dante with a little bit of Lucia mixed in. So. Ooh, snap, crackle, pop, man. So. I'll just go ahead and close that. And yeah. Alright. So yeah, I will. Tomorrow we'll be covering Dante's missions 8 through 11. And Lucia's 7 and 8. And then Wednesday, we'll be covering Dante's 12 through 16. And Lucia's 9. And then Thursday, we'll be covering Lucia's 10, 11, 12, and 13, as well as Dante's last two missions. And then Devil May Cry, the series will be done for me until they put out something new. So hope you guys enjoyed, hope you found it informative, finally got a little bit of story outside the beginning. So let's see where it goes from here. Till then, have a great night. I will see you guys tomorrow, and I'm just gonna piss rain off and end it right there. Not even gonna give you the golden saying, the golden rule, the golden shower. Have a good night, guys. Bye.